Sri Gurudeva Namahachandran, you are in Unit 2 Entrepreneurial Planning, and today we are going to see the different forms of business organization. Now, an enterprise is a separate and distinct unit initially arranged to conduct any type of business activity. Now, setting a business is not an easy task. To accomplish the entrepreneur's desired objective, he needs to combine material, tool, equipment, workspace, and bring together all many other factors in a very systematic and effective manner to achieve a goal. So every business entity needs to select an appropriate legal structure or framework to work in. So this legal structure determines the extent of ownership and responsibility of proprietors. Once selected, changing the form is quite complex, so time-consuming and costly affair. So forms of organization can be classified into three categories. Now they are private, public and joint sector. Now under private you have sole proprietorship, partnership, joint stock company, into undivided family, cooperative society. Under public sector you have departmental undertaking, public corporation, statutory corporation and joint sector. Now we are going to see sole proprietorship. Now, who is the sole proprietor? What do you mean by sole proprietorship? And what type of business activities can he undertake? What is the suitability of a sole proprietorship form of organization? What are the legal requirements? All that we are going to go through this chapter. To begin with, we are going to start with a few definitions, and we are going to see their view. What do they feel about sole proprietorship? So, a sole proprietorship is a business initiated and operated by one individual who carries all financial and administrative responsibilities, employing such assistants as may be necessary. A sole proprietorship is a business unit whose ownership and management are vested in one person. The individual assumes all risk of loss or failure of the enterprise and receives all profit from the successful operations by Edward Hopper. Now, W.R. Bassett, he says, the one-man control is best in the world if that man is big enough to manage everything. Now, next we are going into the meaning of sole proprietorship. So, sole means single, single proprietorship. Another word for single, individual proprietorship. So, business first started with this form of organization. There was no partnership, there was no joint stock company, there was no Hindu undivided family, etc., etc. This was the first form of organization. This is one of the oldest and simplest and most commonly used form of organization. Owned, financed, controlled and managed by only one person. Sole here means single. Proprietor means owner. Next we are going to see the characteristics of proprietorship. The first one is individual ownership. What do you mean by individual ownership? He is a single owner. This business is exclusively owned by a single person. Second is individual management and control. See, the proprietor, he manages individually and he has a total control of his business. So what is to be done, how it is to be done, when it is to be done is all decided by him. Individual finance. So all investment is made by the proprietor. He can borrow from his friends, relatives, all his savings, and then he can start his own business. No separate legal entity. That means he and business are one and the same. So legally the proprietor and the proprietorship are one and the same business and owner exists together. So when the owner dies, the business also dies. Unlimited liability. What do you mean by unlimited liability? The proprietor is liable and responsible for all the losses arising from the business. In case the business assets are insufficient to pay off his liability or her liability, his personal property will be attached and he will be asked to pay his business debt. The next is sole beneficiary. So the sole proprietor alone is entitled to all the profit and loss of the business. So that's why he will put his heart and soul to increase the profit of the business. Easy formation and closure. So there are not much legal formalities to start a sole proprietorship. He is subject to minimum legal formalities and regulations both at the time of commencing and closing the business. So limited area of operation. So the form of business generally has a limited area of operation due to limited financial facility and managing it. So next we are going to suitability of sole proprietorship form of organization. Now it is suitable when? When is it suitable to start a sole proprietorship? So when you have a limited capital, so the capital requirement is very low. If the secrecy is very important, you don't want to share your secret to your partner or to anybody, you want to keep it a secret, then you can start this type of organization. When the market is low, local, okay, within your reach. So when the goods are of artistic nature or demands customized approach for a particular person, you're going to make a diamond ring or a diamond necklace or a diamond merchant. You don't want to share your secrets with anybody. So and then quick decision making is necessary. So you cannot wait. You cannot wait for a long time to take a decision. Now supposing it's going to be a rainy day and you are having a fast food shop and suddenly all of a sudden you may, suddenly you may change your idea. Okay, not samosas. I'm going to start with even bhajias, pork bhajias and different, snacks of that particular season. Immediately you can make a decision. This is only an example. It can differ according to the type of the business. The size of venture is small. So if it's going to be a small business, maybe a petty shop, maybe a fancy store, or maybe a small supermarket, or maybe an electronical gadget shop, or it may be a milk booth or anything, a small type of organization can choose this type of business organization, sole proprietorship form of organization. Legal formalities involved in registration procedure. See, a sole proprietor does not need to be registered and therefore it's a very inexpensive manner of commencing a business. But however, in order to start a sole proprietorship, an entrepreneur requires certain industrial specific license. A few general factors are like first, a business name. So business name, the sole proprietors are under no obligations to select a trade name for their business. Howsoever, they are free to do so if they desire to do. Then service tax registration. Form ST1 is to be filled for registration if taxable services are more than 10 lakhs for a financial year. Then he is supposed to have a PAN card number, a bank account number, name of the business, sole proprietorship business, shop and establishment license, employment provident fund registration, importer exporter code, as and when applicable. So it has to be compiled with whatever, depends upon if you might start as a sole proprietor and end up with an MNC. So as you are growing, there might be a demand for other legal formalities that you have to comply with. Then payment of taxes. A sole trader has to ensure his or her business meets the state and federal tax requirements. Due to the fact that legally a sole tradership and a sole trader are a single entity, the sole trader pays the tax of the. So I hope you understood who is a sole trader. He is a single person who starts the business by himself or herself with the money that he has or with the money that he has borrowed from his friends, his relatives. And then he starts the company. It's not necessary it should be a sole proprietor throughout. If your venture is very successful and if you're very lucky and people start liking your product, then you're going to become an MNC. So here are some examples of people who just started as a sole proprietor and ended up into an MNC. Now for example, so Tom Monahan, he was the founder of Domino Pizzas. He actually started a pizza corner in 1960 and he just borrowed $900 along with his brother Jim. But somehow Jim left within the year and Tom continued. And he was a very hardworking person and he almost worked for 18 hours a day and 7 days a week. And he wholeheartedly made Domino Pizzas a giant MNC, world over household name. So a very successful journey for one big man. So it was a sole proprietorship form of organization which slowly became an MNC. We have another example for a case study, that is Aristotle Onassis. He was one of the richest men in the world in 1960 and then he migrated to Argentina from Greece. So when he was 16, he landed a big tobacco order and he reinvested in the petty business. He accumulated more money and his small business was eventually built into a great financial empire. So he became one of the richest man in the world. And you have another great example. He is an Indian, Satya Bharta Day. He is the owner of Sri Leather, sir. So in 1986, he left his home in Jamshedpur and he came to Calcutta with a few thousand rupees in his hands, which was given by his mother. And now he is a millionaire, a crorepati. He just started a small shop in a corner of Calcutta. And he started selling shoes, you know, ladies' slippers. He started with 6 pairs of ladies' slippers. He didn't even borrow money, that much only he had. He didn't want to borrow money and a lot of liability in his thingy. He started a small business, a small shop, and his father was already having a shoe shop in Jamshedpur, a small shop, where he already acquired the skill of making shoes. So he started making shoes, and customers were very pleased with the way he was making shoes. You know, normally when you buy a slipper or shoe, you always feel that it should be durable, it should last for a long time. So his shoes, you know, were very lasting for a long time. People started liking it, and very soon his like, you know, people were talking about the shoes, and slowly people who already purchased from him, again they came back and they brought more customers. And he was so successful, and he's such a very you know, like a very successful person. And he started his business, and he had his own philosophy of doing business. And for him, customer service was the prime importance. He cut out a lot of middlemen, and he always kept his employees very happy. And he was like, he started growing and growing because of all these qualities. You know, like, he used to work very hard. And slowly now you see he's selling shoes not only in India but in Greece, Austria, Netherlands, Germany, UK, USA. So it is Sri Leathers is worth several crores today. And the young man who came to Calcutta with only the clothes on his back and a fistful of money has come a long way. And nothing, the secret is hard work and dignity of labor and big dreams. So I hope you understood who is a sole trader and what is a sole trader form of organization. And next class you're going to see partnership. So I have a small assignment attached along with this class. So apart from the few examples which I have listed above, I want you to list two more persons who have started a sole proprietor, and today they are today that business has become an MNC. So each answer should not exceed 250 words. Okay, so I hope you understood the lesson, and we'll see you in the next class with partnership form of organization. Thank you, children.